Hi guys, it's Mike here, One Go Short Play, recording from a very messy office. Yeah, basically, as those of you who've watched any of my gaming videos recently will know, I've had a change of job, change of situation. That basically meant selling stuff. I'm not selling any of my games consoles yet, you can see them in the background there. So, to the point, I wanted to maybe try and interact a bit more on YouTube. I found myself being able to watch YouTube and work. The job I do now is less thought intensive. Once I'm on a roll, I can stick YouTube on in the background and I can listen to the YouTube channels a bit more than I could, which is great. And it made me realise that I can probably do a better job on my YouTube channel, or at least find a way to get back to my YouTube channel and be a bit more involved with the YouTube community. And the irony was, I was watching Mamemeister's video about the three main positives and negatives of having a YouTube channel, and they were very much on my mind at the time, being as I'm trying to get back into the habit of it, because I really enjoy it in ways that I just didn't ever expect. And I miss it. I miss it while I'm not doing it. And because life's been in such a state of upheaval at the minute, I've really missed it. So I thought, if it's okay with you, man, I'd answer your questions and try and be a better YouTuber. Now, as I say, this isn't normally my format. Well, if it is, I'm usually wandering about my office, but I can't today because it's a state. Basically, it is a state. I thought I'd start with negative, and then positive, and then negative, and then positive, because they kind of counter each other, I found. And also, I like to end on a positive note, and I feel more positive about my YouTube channel than I do negative, so it only seems fair to finish on a positive note. I apologise again for the amateurish display of handheld iPhone camera. It's just the way things have got to be at the moment, and I'll come to that. Okay, so I'll get to the positives and negatives, and I'll start with the first negative. My first negative with having a YouTube channel has been finding the time. Now, I know this is one that a lot of people say, this stuff doesn't pay yet. All it is really is a hobby, but time has been so difficult to find lately, mainly because my work has been in such a state of upheaval, and also because we've got a 17 month old baby, toddler. He's taken up the last year and a bit, and I've got a feeling it'll take up a few more years, and if we have another one, which is not unlikely, yeah, it's going to be rough finding time, and I'm trying to figure out ways to balance that out, and you know, we're getting there, and I think we will get there, and if you bear with me, I do want to carry this on and keep doing it. I'm just not sure what the terms are yet. When I started, I had time. I was a part-time artist and partly a freelancer. And that meant basically that I was able to break up my workload in such a way that I'd have an hour for lunch and I could just at my home office get my camera out. My iPhone out, or me microphone and my setup out, and record a few games, and I was able to release one a day at that point. It was just rolling along nicely. It was brilliant, and I really enjoyed it, and I felt really productive. My other hobby, which I've had for a while, is game dev. As a little indie developer, Psychotic Software, if you're interested, little plug there, or Psysoft on Twitter. I haven't been able to game dev as much either, and that's made me sad, as much as the lack of YouTubing has. Now, let's move on to a positive, eh? The thing about this channel is, when I started it, it was because I was working at a games company, it was because I was making games, it was because I needed something more audio than visual in the background, and I wanted, at the time, to see Amiga games, but I didn't want to see like 2 hours of beginning to end footage of Amiga games. What I wanted to see was, I don't know, a couple of minutes of gameplay just happening, so I could click to it, go, oh right, that's what that game looked like, click back to my work and carry on. And I thought, there's probably a place for what I wanted to do, which at the time was just quickly play through up to 10 minutes of Amiga games. Yeah, I get the chance to play games. This is my way of playing games, and I haven't played any games for ages. Just working home, play with the Baba, which is brilliant, and I would not miss that. In fact, I'd miss out on games before I missed out on playing with him, but it's my way of getting to play games. So my kit's rubbish. I'm currently looking at an image of myself on a smashed iPhone screen. Toddler, don't ask. We can't afford to update it. This is a 4S. I've got a feeling it's going to die on its backside any day now, but while it's alive, I've got to make do, and it takes videos, hey. A few years ago, that was such a luxury. This takes videos, it works. I'd like to spend a few £100 on a good camera. I don't need to if I've got this, and at least I've got this. I've got a microphone over there, which is, it's a blue microphone, so it's like a USB one. It wasn't cheap, and I got it when we were a bit better off, but it's all a bit falling apart, you know? My kit is a bit rubbish. It's a bit of a negative. It's not a biggie. Back to the positives. This is an outlet, a creative outlet. I'm, I suppose, for want of a better word, a creative. I'm a very generalist, I guess, as a creative. I've been a games artist most of my career, but I'm not like a specialist. I don't do like just making 3D weapons or whatever. I do everything, and I mean everything from vector art, games icons, character animation, background environments, 2D and 3D, everything. That means I'm not amazing at any one thing, but I'm good at everything. But the same applies with programming, with, well, what I'm trying to say is when I was a young teenager, I was in a band, I was the songwriter, I was the singer, I was the rhythm guitarist. We gigged, we recorded, we were pretty good. I guess if we worked a bit harder, we might have got signed. If we gigged a bit more, we might have got noticed a bit more. But we had good songs, we got on the radio, we achieved things, we won battles of the bands and stuff like that. And we were good. It was a massively important outlet to me then, and I miss it, I do miss it. Because, you know, you get old and fat and bald and ugly, and you can't be a rock star if you're old and fat and bald and ugly like me. But, you know, the skills are still there, and the urge to do it is still there, it doesn't go away. And I miss that a bit. And I need to replace the outlets every now and then if you have to change. And that was one that I had to change. I did that in my mid-teens and me, and then again later on with the same band in my mid-20s. So that was a really important outlet. When I was in my late teens, I had to go to comics. Now, as I say, I'm not a brilliant specialist. And I think a comic artist has to be a brilliant comic artist that really focuses on comic art. And I didn't. And what I did was really stylish and really good for my age and my experience at the time. But again, it would have taken me a few years of practicing my art to get better at it, and I wasn't as into comics as you'd have to be to do that. So I did write a comic or two and didn't really try and do it with them because I knew there wasn't a career in it, but it was a massive outlet again, and it took me months and months of sitting there writing and drawing and coming up with ideas and translating them to visuals, and that was a massive outlet too. It was a very private outlet that I didn't really share it until I'd finished. It was still an outlet, and it was something that kept my little overactive brain busy. If I don't do something, I sort of tend to sort of self-destruct, and that's not pretty. And then I guess into my 20s, me early 20s, there was film and animation, but mostly film. I got groups of my student mates together and made films, mostly about zombies, sometimes sci-fi movies, but they were all, the idea was on a really low budget, and we'd all achieve something, an accomplishment really, for no budget. And visually we did some amazing stuff. And you know, when I think about the prosthetic effects that we managed to achieve, when I think about the digital effects we managed to achieve, and the music we managed to compose, and you know, the fun we had doing it as a team, it took up so much of our time and effort and so much of our thought processes, and we'd kind of lie awake at night thinking about what was coming next, how we could make it better, and it was that kind of passion. And I loved it, and I miss it, and I haven't got those people around me anymore, and I don't know. I realised when I was making films, I could make things look nice, and I could make them kind of cut pretty well. That's a practice thing. But what I was a bit rubbish at was writing stories and writing characters. And I was just rubbish at it. And I there were mates who were good at it, but I couldn't find anyone who'd write and work with me to make films that looked and sounded good. Any of my mates who could write could also do the rest of it. So, you know. Yeah, so I kind of gave up on films after a while. Then there was games. Back in the Amiga days, as a kid and a teenager, I couldn't program, but I did the artwork. And I didn't know anyone who could program well enough to get a game finished. In recent years, I've kind of taught myself that. All right, just using Adobe Director lingo, and then using C# to make an Xbox game. And I still mostly return to Director just because it's easy and I can get my ideas from here onto a screen. But you know, if I find the time, I'm sure I'll probably use Unity for the next job, or maybe whatever the big thing is, and then if it's a couple of years away, my next game. But games have been my outlet for a long time now, and also to play, they've been my outlet. Making a game, one single game, takes like 2 years. When you're on your own, you know, and that's not to do even a big console game. So it's a lot of work for relatively little reward, financially definitely. But to see your game finished is rewarding itself, and that's brilliant. But that takes time, and this YouTube channel is a much more instantly gratifying process, getting these videos done and out there, even if no one sees them, and that is an issue that I'll come back to. Even if no one sees them, it's brilliant. It's brilliant to see them yourself. I do have to admit, I occasionally watch my own videos back, you know, from a while ago to see how they went, and think, oh, that was actually funnier than I remember it being. So I thought, I don't know what people make of it. I'm sure people aren't that into it, because I've only got a couple hundred followers, and I think only a few of them ever watch my videos. But thanks if you do, that's really good. But I like it. And you know, this is one of my outlets at the moment, and it's one that I want to rekindle because I really enjoy doing it. It does bring me to another negative, especially early on in the days of my channel when I'd put about 50 or 60 videos out. I was envious of other YouTubers who were doing really well, and I just couldn't figure out how they did it. And I was just not getting the followers, not getting people engaging. And I couldn't figure out why, and I think I've started to now. It's taken me a few years to, but I think I've started to figure it out. At first, this no one was watching my videos got me down. And then I developed a sort of weird sense of pride in it. And if anyone did ask about it, use the same phrase, and I still do, it's gloriously unsuccessful. And sometimes I'll put a video up and six people will view it, and I'll check back to it a year later and eight people have viewed it, you know, and that's pretty gloriously unsuccessful. I guess it doesn't really matter to me now, but it did for a while there. I mean, it really upset me for a while there, but I just kept going because, you know, you've got to show a bit of heart, haven't you? To yourself, if no one else, and so I kept at it. I'm hoping I'm figuring it out. I realised that the way I was watching YouTube, especially lately, was I was just catching up every, you know, month or so, just going, oh, what are me people I'm following doing, and checking them out, and the videos I was watching, I'm watching them about 3 weeks after they've been done, which of course is not really good for interacting with the other YouTubers and the other people there. Since I've been working this new job, and since I've been able to watch YouTube as a consumer, which is not something I did much, I found myself watching more recent videos. For example, Mamemeister's video about positives and negatives, the one I'm replying to right now. This is probably my first video reply to anyone else's video, and it's just an experiment to see, I guess, if it does actually make interaction happen and make me more interactive with these people that I really watch and really admire, and they just don't know it because all they see of me is me putting gaming videos up and not talking to anyone. And I think part of me's just been terrified, basically, of interacting with these people that I look up to. That's not a surprise, really. I mean, I've always been of the mindset of never meet your heroes. A, you'd probably be let down because the people, and B, I would just make a debut of myself face to face because I'm quite a shy person, really. I'm not outgoing. I'm not an extrovert. I am very much an introvert. I'm uncomfortable in public. I'm uncomfortable with other people. I try not to show it, and I don't think it does show too much. But I'm so much more comfortable when I'm at home, cozy and snug in my little space. But so I want to try and put myself out there a bit more. So hello. So yeah, that was a bit of a negative. Was at first how rubbish my channel was doing. It kind of still is, but I guess that's just the nature of it, and if you love doing it, you do it, and I do love doing it, so I want to do it more. On the other side of it, another positive, and a really massive positive for me that I didn't really see coming when I started the channel. As I say, I was making it just to make the sort of videos I wanted to make, but a massive positive that came out of it was the camaraderie and the interaction. Now, I've only had a few regular viewers who write comments on my videos, but I really appreciate those guys. I've seen these guys comment on other people's videos, so they know the community very well. When I had to get off YouTube for a bit to get on with, you know, life, it worried me when I got back into it that everyone would have gone. But most people have stuck around, and that's really cool. And not only that, but the people who were commenting on my videos, I'm talking about the likes of Papa Chuck, and I'm talking about the likes of Mark Morose, and I'm talking about the likes of Zedek Specky, who've commented on me latest videos when I got back. And whenever I do disappear for a bit, and I have to sometimes, they're always there for me when I come back. And that's really cool. And I didn't expect anything like that, because, you know, I expected, I'll be honest, in terms of comments, I expected trolling. And just people saying you're doing it wrong, or you're rubbish, you know. And I did get a couple at the beginning, but I just stuck with it, and they went away. I'd say it's much more of a positive, the responses I've got. And I'm not saying that people have said I'm really good, but people are just there talking back about the games and the videos. And I've learned a lot about the games because of these people, and a lot about the consoles and the computers because of these people. And I'm dead grateful for that. It's a massive plus. I love doing this. I've missed it. I'm not very good at it. I'm not very outgoing. But if you're ever considering interacting with me or replying to me or saying hello or doing a video or something, although I've never thought to actually put a question out there, which is a scary thought in itself, don't hesitate to, because I'd like to be part of the community more so than I am now, if that's all right with you. Anyway, I'm rambling now. There's my three positives and negatives. They're a bit messy. I'm going to sift through this and cut it down, because there's a lot of umming and ahhing in this video. Thanks for the welcome back. thanks very much for watching.